We're gonna do some standing centering, getting our bodies into a place of great awakening. Not necessarily needing to always find center, but we do wanna find that dynamic place from which we can move and find our tensions and put them into flow. So we're gonna take a deep breath, lift your arms and your shoulders, shrug as high as you can. Welcome the day, welcome whatever your body is saying to you, kind of feel around. And then exhale, push the air out and really use that deep upper thoracic flexion as that push. And then we inhale, take in fresh air, lengthen, do any little micro adjustments that you need to start getting into the nooks and crannies. And exhale, press, push, push, push. Good, again. Inhale, take in that cold air and let it bathe your brain. Watch it go down your cerebral spinal fluid. And then exhale and push. A deep, deep flexion. One more time, inhale, lift. Find the volume inside of your body, the breadth and the depth of where you exist and inhabit. And then exhale, push. We're gonna take a step out to the right. Inhale and take up the space on the side of your body, and then exhale back to flexion. Inhale left, stretch and spread your body across the canvas of space, and exhale. Find the expanding and then the compressing in each moment, like that push and pull of the syringe, moving the fluid through the tissues. And that becomes the hydraulic movement for pushing life through the tissues and then drawing its septic tension out. Inhale, press. And exhale, pull. Inhale, press. And you don't be afraid to expand and to exaggerate a little bit. Overextend your back. And then feel that opposite complement. Inhale. And exhale, one more inhale, and exhale, stay over to the right, little pulses, one. And we're gonna work through that foot, rolling in the ball and the heel. As you bend and put weight into the hip, distribute front through the knee, back through the hip, front through the knee, back through the hip. And when those are done in equal portions, you find that beautiful place of dynamic alignment. Three and two and one. Take your arm and we're just gonna do a little bit of free circling, continuum circles. I'm still kind of like dropping into my heel as my arm drops. We're looking for like a synchronicity of load, push and push. Four, three, two, and one. Great. Stay here for a second and just swing your arm because we're gonna then go back over to the right, karate chop the left. We're gonna activate a little bit of the lymph and get into the traps. I'm holding my hand like kind of a blade. And when I lean over to the right, I karate chop. And I'm just hacking away at this tension that rests right at our collarbones. The weight of the world on our shoulders. And as I tick-tock, I'm allowing my body to just carry and press and flow. You can kind of change the alignment, come a little bit more into the collarbone where we wake up the tensions of the pec. And then you can reach back over your shoulder and hit a little bit on the back of your body. Push, four more. Four. Three, two, and one. Good, back to center. Great, other side. Step out to the second side. It might be your left, it might be your right, depending upon what you're facing. But we're gonna roll through the foot all the way back to the top of that sequence. Activating those points of suspension and lift. The heel drops, the knee goes forward, hip goes back. Chest stretches up and away. Pressing on four and three and two and beautiful, one. Stay there. And we're just gonna do some of that continuum swing with the arm. Press, open, and still let it come off your center line, the center channel, and press. Push four, and three, and two, and one. Really nice carving through that space. Stay here for a second and just swing that arm to get the rhythm. And then when you go and swing up over your left shoulder, head over to the left, sorry, over to the right shoulder, we're gonna do the karate chop. And I'm trying to hack right where the shoulder meets the neck, thick tension, kind of the thumb area of my hand hits and cradles in there. And I'm letting my spine start to find, even through the neck, some of that movement. Instead of like side bending and keeping your head straight, you're trying to feel and encourage your neck to have that same bending that your spine does. Press. Good. Four, three, two, and one. Good, bring it back to center. We're gonna step out to the first side. We're gonna lunge again. You're gonna then dive over, cross the body into a lunge on the left. We're gonna do an elevation change. So I go up on the right, over on the left. Let's try it again. Up on the right, over to the left. Inhale, lift high. Exhale, drop over. Inhale, and exhale, reach. Inhale, and pull. Press into that foot to help you build the sequence. When I come back from the left, I push into my left leg, I push into my pelvis, I come up and I carry that through my chest. Let's do three more. Three, and two, and one, and great. Stay over to the left, stretch your inner thigh on the right, little pulses. Eight, you wanna feel that you're exaggerating the crease in your right hip and allowing for the tissue to spread and become more supple. Three, two, one. Great. Turn gently into the lunge on your left leg. Compress your chest forward and then come back to the side. Twist and lunge into the left leg. Try to drop and compress your spine forward on your thigh. So instead of being up like this, you're really working the fold in the hip and then release. Four. And three. Load and then release. Two. And release. And one. Place your left or back leg on the ground. We're gonna do a little pulse forward into the front of that hip. And as I pulse and I load, I'm still lifting up and out. So let the load come from the fold rather than from the tuck of your pelvis. Four, three, two, one. Glide left and right. Just shift your pelvis. Feel like you're really working with a batter in a bucket. How the internal tissues start to open and contour the inner surfaces of your body. Find those extra moments of release. Two and one. Grab around. This may cramp your hamstring, but let's give it a shot. You're gonna press the hip and drop forward, pull up and back. Inhale, try to get all the way through the extension of your spine, and then lift up and back. Inhale, as you load into the front of that quad, it's quite tight. Really feel the scattering, how the tissue scatters when you spread and load. Two, and release. One more. Oof. Ay, ay, ay. Rock right and left a little bit. I'm just doing a tiny rotation to flare the tissue. So when the tissues run in a certain direction, we can actually create more opening by cross rubbing or creating rotation across the front of the hip. So try four more of those. Four, and three, and two, right on that kneecap, and one, release, great. Come back to your parallel lunge to the left. That leg now has been stretched, so see if you can get a little deeper into that hip socket, and then we can come back and release. Great. I'm gonna show the whole thing on the left. I don't know if it's more helpful when I turn back away, but let's see. So, the first side is this. So we're gonna go left up, and then we're gonna go over and load into the right leg. I spring back into the left and lift, and then I go over into that right, kind of a one-sided quad, squat. Inhale, lift, and exhale, press, chest drops. Inhale, build the sequencing up through the foot, and then back and down. Inhale, up and through. Exhale, drop the third quartile forward, and the third, first quartile pulls up. Three, and press. Two, inhale, and press. And one more, inhale, and exhale, release. Great. Little pulses on that right thigh. So you're getting more of the pressure into the inner side of your left hip. On the load, you create the length. The load is coming in from the top of the hip, and then you spread it wide. Four, three, two, one. Turn out your right leg, go into a stride lunge. Make your back exhale forward of your femur. And then come back into that kind of Kozak lunge, Vitruvian lunge. Switch again, rotate. Do this on exhale. So you're really getting that compression towards the floor, which creates displacement from head to foot. And back to the center. Three more. Exhale. Paint that tissue deep and wide. And lunge, and two, and release. One last time, exhale, do a couple pulses here. Drop deeper into hip flexion on the front bent leg. Let your chest massage forward, diaphragm drops. Four, three, two, one, drop that back knee. And we're gonna pull back, and then you're gonna come forward. With the knee bent, you're still being able to drop into the whole body rather than tucking the pelvis. Spread it through the whole spine, and release. Two, and release. As you're loading forward, lift backwards. So there's still this quality of support, not just full obliteration into that hip. Stay forward, let's glide. Body right and left, I'm shifting my weight between my hands. I'm allowing there to be that batter in a bucket feel. And releasing. Four, and three. Good, two. And one, fabulous. Take your right arm and grab onto your back foot. We're gonna do the same thing. So you pull back, take the load off. As you go forward, you're going to try to lift and arch. I need to do this so much more often. This is excruciating. And then my quad was much looser than this. Inhale, pull, and exhale, draw. Loading in, feel the scatter of the tissues. And then we pull back. Inhale. And press. Let's do two more. Try to develop and cultivate that all the way through the spine. And lengthen. And one more. Stay forward. And then just little hip glides like we did with the leg down. But we're fraying across laterally in the front of the quad. Four. And three. And two. Oh my gosh. And one. That makes me want to sweat. And bring back to that nice right lunge. And then to the center. Whew. Keep your legs wide for a second. You're going to gently bend your knee to the floor. It rotates your hip in. And then you're going to come back up. Roll the hip and drop that knee. It's almost like I feel like I have a center line on the mat. And what I'm looking for is that as you rotate the leg in, there's a lifting up and back of that first quartile. I can kind of feel it actually taxing the strength of my quad and VMO because of my, I'm up on my toes, on my foot. So we'll do a couple more. You're gonna press, drop, and you're reaching the knee to the floor, but the first quartile to pull up and down. Taking space in the hip socket for our pulses in a minute. And two, and release, and one. Let's stay to that left side, and we're just gonna pulse, stay on the toe, and I'm gonna repeat going deeper into that stretch line. The knee drops, and I pull, four. And three, you guide where the tension moves. It's very interesting as I change my tissue, I get more and more kind of quaky in different places. Two and one, good. Other side, up on the toe, knee falls to the center line, knee drops down, pelvis lifts up. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Really nice. Come back out. We're gonna escape with the Vitruvian wide legs. You're gonna take your arms up and we're gonna roll down. We're gonna walk out, load into our arms. Drop the hips, lift into a plank, and as you do, push your arms away from you. And so I'm actually acting as if I'm moving the hands, or the effort I'm generating is up and away, and I lift back and through. Inhale, load, plank first. Then you can break through the plank wall to stretch. Then you lift your first quartile up and feel that your pushing of your arms away pushes the hips up and back. Again, inhale, plank. Drop the hips. Open the sternum, belly button drops. Then we lift, pull, all the way up and back, let the heels release. Nice, one more time, inhale, plank. Hold true and lengthen. Rock and roll your pelvis and allow your shoulder to kind of elevate as you walk. If this is too tight on your tummy, two things you can do, walk your hands farther away from you or widen them. However, you still have to get up and back in a minute. So do what you can to open the front line simply by how you tell the body and the organs to relax. Four, give a wash to those organs. Feel how your guts get to kind of glide on the inside of you. Three, two, and one. Up and back. Great. Here we go. So you're going to stay back and we're going to wag our tail from right to left. You're going to use the strength in your upper body to keep creating suspension back. And I want you to start twisting. First, our first set is going to be without the heels and the toes twisting. Just feel how it goes and opens across the calf. And then with the second one, let your hips go and your feet will almost change direction. Like they're almost wagging to the right and to the left with your heels. And press, four more, four, and three, and let the hip pull you deep into that thoracic mid-back flexion and rotation. Two, and one. Great, bring your feet together. We're going to go forward into a plank, back into a prowl. Forward into a plank, back into a prowl. Keep the knees moving through together. Find what it's like to use your first quartile to suspend weight up and over your heels. And exhale. Let's do this and we're gonna focus. Come down just for a second. I wanna explain it while your body is slightly resting because I'm gonna make you do this a couple times and I want there to be still integrity. When we get tired, our musculoskeletal biomechanics erodes. So just stretch your wrists while you listen. We're gonna make this a strength exercise, but we're gonna focus on it as if it's a breathing exercise. When we go into a plank, it's gonna take us and pull this way. And then when we go back, we're pushing and pulling it out. You know those old, they fuel the fire. I can't even think about it right now. A billow, maybe that's what it's called, a billow. And so this body is gonna pull and exhale. I want you to be quite aggressive. It's gonna do for you what we used to do in the studio with the spring bar and the breathing, where you push down on the springs. That's literally the action here. And you're trying to inhale when everything is pulled tight. When you pull fascia tight, it gets long and skinny. And so then the volume of your breath goes in as a stretch. The basic principles of opposition. So we're gonna do this 8 times. We're gonna take a break. I'm gonna stretch you on side and side. And then we're gonna do another one for your strength in your arms. Everybody understand? Let us go. Here we go. Coming forward. Also make sure your fingers are pointed outward. We don't teach fingers forward in GST. They are out like a grip, not forward, and that will help your wrists quite a bit. All right, here we go. So starting, you're gonna inhale, suspend your body forward, and then exhale, push from your back to get your air. Feel spit coming out of your mouth. Inhale. It's so hard for me to take a breath in there. Inhale, bigger, bigger. Inhale. How do you keep suspension when you're exhaling? Two. One. Stay in the exhale 8 pulses. Exhale, exhale. You should run out of air. Bring yourself back. Roll up through the spine. Little rotation of the arms. Let them hit your pecs. Start to get some percussion. Why don't we do this actually? As you rotate on your break, hit your pec. Hit, hit. Kind of like you're a gorilla. And as you're hitting, you almost like present the chest to the hand as much as the hand is releasing back. Four. Three. Two. One. Good. Shrug your shoulders, get your collarbones to lift. And then exhale. Inhale. Try to go in and loosen up the sternum. And exhale. Two. Lift and get the sternum. And exhale. One more time. Inhale. Up into the sternoclavicular junction. And exhale. Great. Feels good. I like it. Let's do our second set. Here we go. and up on the toes. On our last set of pulses with the exhale, the only change I want you to make is instead of just pulsing back and up, I want you to try to drop your hips to the right and left. So we're really getting the exhale as the rotation through your floating ribs. Here we go. 8 breaths in and inhale and exhale, push. Inhale. And fight for that inhale. The shape makes you restricted. So you have to really push the air. And exhale. 3. Wow, that's really good. I like it. Take your feet wider, bring your hands more narrow in front of you. Last thing, we're gonna actually release the arm, go into a nice kind of plank on the side, and then we're gonna come back. You're gonna inhale, rotate, release the other arm, and then come back. Inhale, and exhale. Inhale, and 3, 2, 1. Let's actually finish. I think I opened first with my left because of the way I'm facing. So finish your set and press. Last thing, little drop of the elbow forward for tricep presses. You're lifting up in the hips as you lower your elbows to the floor. 8 times. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, and 2, and 1. Great. All the way back. Roll your shoulders. Let's do one more set of twisting before you move on. Here we go. Inhale, inhale, exhale. Exhale. Three. Two. One. And release. Great, you guys. I love. Let's go ahead and have a seat on the ground. And I'm gonna start with a little bit of rocking and rolling, and then we're gonna move on to some leg and hip stuff. Flex your feet, grab onto your ankles, pull your nipples up and forward of your knees. You should feel that your whole rib cage is trying to compress forward and through. Now, this is very similar to what I was having you try to feel in this lunge. Instead of gravity helping you, it's now you have to creating a resistance for you. And so you're going to grab and pull, inhale, arch up and really stretch your chin and neck, almost like you're doing a yawn and a lying yawn. Inhale, and then release. The way I picture this is that my QL, my lumbar spine, is licking this way, and then my ribs and nipples are licking, and then my jaw, the scalene. So I'm actively creating suspension through all 3 major centers in the body. I'm pulling with my arms, but I'm animating my tissue so that it becomes strong through the range of motion I'm trying to perform. Here we go, 4 times. You will feel a pinching in your hip more or less, especially if you don't have good hip flexion. When you feel the pinch in your hip, pull the first quartile back and through to clear it. I used to feel like I had actual substance stuck in my hip, and I would just gently lick the first quartile, and slowly that pinch that almost feels nervy will go away. So here we go, 4 times. And inhale, pull. Feel that compression. It's activating your lymph in your groin. Feel how your ribs and lungs fill forward. Yawn and do your lion's roar. And then release everything. Shake and nod your head again. Inhale, lower back lick, upper nipple lick, jaw and tongue. Push and release. Shake and nod. Two more. I'm quaking, quivering, that's really funny. Inhale, pull, lick up, pull up, chin up, and release. Shake and nod when you come forward. And let's do one more. Hips, pull, ankles, lick from the low back, lick from your mid back, lick through your jaw and your chin. Eight pulses at the top, go. Eight, seven, and you want to feel that you're getting nice stretch. It should not be rolling your chest forward and then you cramming your neck. Let me show you what it's not, this, okay? You're in charge of making sure that you get that mid back to release into the jaw. Four, three, two, one, and release. Great. Here we go. Just gently start a rolling and rocking and forward. I'm putting my fingers facing my heels so that when I rock forward, I'm also getting a big palm and elbow and shoulder stretch. Here we go. Inhale, roll. And exhale, come forward and launch yourself. Almost like instead of pulling from your ankles, you're kind of launching yourself back from your arms forward in your chest. Inhale. And then exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Fill that breath into the front of your lungs. It creates suspension rather than filling into your back. Never breathe into your back body. Exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Four. And feel how the floor, the earth massages your rib cage as you roll. Three. Stretch the fingers and the palms through the wrists and the carpal tunnel. And two, and press. I'm doing this with my knees bent, and I'm really working on creating strength enough in my torso that I'm not laying on my body, but I'm pulling weight up and out of my shoulders. And then I come forward. Now, bring your legs together, straight legs, try to kiss your knees. Come forward, try to launch to your toes, knees, nose to knees. Inhale, pull, and exhale, flow. Great. Inhale, up and back, and exhale, nose to knees. Oh my gosh, nothing makes me feel unflexible and old like this. Why? I don't understand. And if you can tell, I have emotional resistance all over this one. Hence why we dip in. Get our feet wet to the things that make it slightly uncomfortable. Inhale and exhale, roll. Touch the knees to the nose. Now, even when your knees are dropping to your nose, it is not a compression or a drop in your rib cage. You're actually thrusting higher in the hip and lengthening deeper into the foot. And that, or lowering the foot over you. Good, two more. And keep the lift, and then lengthen the hamstrings. Feed your core down the tube of your leg, and press. Now we're gonna just switch. You're going to drop the knees to the nose. As you come forward, lean into the center. Launch your hands into your crotch. Try to pull yourself through. We're gonna do inner thigh stuff, yes? Here we go. Inhale, oops, your legs together. When you come forward, they lower, launch. Spread the inner thighs. Collect from your first quartile. Lift, suspend, And then you come forward. Push and launch. Up. Good. Roll in, lengthen. And then massage your back and create that lift. And three more. Inhale. Find that your legs are lowering from the equatorial line, also not from your hip. That might be another way to think about that stretch. Good. Last two. Inhale. Organizing your animation through the core tiles. And one more. Inhale, lift. And exhale, press. Oh my goodness. And turn to the right leg and lunge forward. I put my right hand behind me and my left hand in front. And I'm just doing the gentle rock up and over my hips. Eight, with my chest rotated. Seven, six, five, four, three, two, one.
Thank you for watching. If you're ready to dive deeper, join us at the Vital Life Studio where you can start your 7-day free trial, access the full-length version of this class, and explore over 400 more videos. I'll see you in the next session.